Establishing battlefield control. Stand by. Unit lost. Incoming transmission.
The time machine is just south of the Golden Gate Bridge.
The Golden Gate Bridge entrance was destroyed by the Soviets during the war. Protect the time machine until you can capture enough power plants to bring it online. Be careful, Commander. Yuri's initiates are combing the city. They want those power plants too. Commander, these are Guardian GIs. They're armed with both machine guns and anti-tank rockets. When deployed, they are able to reduce a tank into scrap metal in seconds. Battle control online.
So the main thing about this, obviously, is just getting this IFV down training as soon as possible and putting him in the building space.
Unit
one ready away from the fence. And then Guardian GIs, because that kind of speeds up the next part the most out of anything you could do first up here. Building some IFVs and some GIs, moving the rally point, moving the guys, etc. Moving them all the way up there, you'll see there's a reason for that.
Commander, the time machine is powered up. We're ready to make the time shift.
Woo-hoo! Let's shake it, baby!
Hang on, this is going to be a close one.
Putting them up there makes it so the Grand Cannon
it will be quite painless
won't hit them because the apocalypses won't be next to them, and then also not putting them next to the pillbox so the dreadnoughts don't hit them, because if some of them die it actually does slow down your time a considerable amount. That's why I moved that one away. I'm going to sell the three top cannons, one to get power, two, so they don't fire at the frickin' GIs and kill them.
But we couldn't have come at a worse time.
And then I did the GIs on a waypoint from the first building to the second building. Getting these right up to the edge is pretty important for your time. Making sure all the IFVs are up there too, because they won't. Automatically go up there, obviously.
Unit promoted. Unit lost.
She could make the rally point there, of course. Having the dog net right next to the time machine, so when she comes out, you can kill her right away.
Reinforcements.
And that's about it.
Mission accomplished. Establishing battlefield control. Stand by. Incoming transmission.
This mission is, I would say, the hardest.
Commander, your MCV is in position near the Los Angeles International
next
Airport.
To Clones Down Under, mission 4.
Sir,
it's just there's so many little precise
LAX
things that I do. I don't know if they're all necessary for the fastest time or whatever, but
incoming transmission.
It's just so many little things that always freaking go wrong. It's
Commander,
crazy.
The enemy is
like,
using a horrifying new technology.
every other time I do it too, like something will happen that I've never seen before. It just leaves me speechless. I'm
They're
like, what
these grinders
the
with captive civilians,
fuck?
Reducing them to raw materials used to fund their war efforts. Yuri's clones are not as powerful as the original, but their ability to control minds is a definite threat on the battle control online.
So here I just used the P command to select
new
all combatants,
options.
And then I moved him up.
You found a movie action
if you go straight up, you'll discover this guy faster. And then I just click on the building, making the Guardian GIs go right next to it as well. I used to build a wall around the Guardian GIs, completely enclosing them, but I figured it doesn't really matter unless I'm trying to be fancy. It did create a really effective defensive structure, but it doesn't really matter. Build an engineer right away. Send this guy an attack move to rescue the other guy. And make sure that you do it, like, when he's already sufficiently to the left, otherwise he'll go to the right of that wall and die. I'm sending the engineer up to capture the hospital. The spot that I send him to is like Well, it has to be pretty precise, because there's a building that gets garrisoned up there, and then also there's task forces that go by there a lot that could get him if you don't put him in the right spot. Of course, again, I don't know if that's the best way to do it or whatever. Leaving this guy here because this Gatling tank comes after him, and it's just really inconvenient if you have to, like, stop and kill the Gatling tank, like start moving and then stop and then start again. So I just wait for him to come, and the helicopter won't be ready before he gets there anyway, so... Sending these GIs up, they're ultimately going to kill one of the grinders, the top right one. But on their way there, they rescue the second hero and fuck some shit up as well.
Structure garrisoned.
So as soon as they fire on that tank, it's part of the task force designated as guarding that guy, so it'll free him right away. And if those tanks aren't dead, then they will go, or if they're not engaged, they will go shoot at the guy, which, I mean, is just mildly annoying. I'm going to move these guys on a waypoint a little bit behind the Yuris. Okay, my engineer is in the right place now to start moving and actually capture the hospital now. These task forces will go right to the right of the hospital, like right over there where my mouse is. They will end up killing that prism tower, actually, because there's so, I mean, there's so many that go by there. It's whatever comes from the base to the left, I would imagine, because... Yeah, it wouldn't be convenient for them to come from the other one. So sending this helicopter up, avoiding the Gatling cannons, guarding that one grinder, putting him on the spot on this hill here to avoid the Gatling cannon there, and then making sure that the hero who can kill anything is in front there, because otherwise these three Gatling tanks will just kill one of your heroes, and you left with your dick in your hand. Killing that tank bunker isn't essential, but it might help you. I mean, the more stuff you kill, the more likely that they'll sell everything at the right time in the end. So I just kill it. I mean, I've had times where I didn't kill it and they didn't sell everything. So making sure that this Gatling tank comes from the upper left, because if he doesn't, then he'll kill your helicopter as you're flying over to get to the other base. So make sure that he either engages you or you engage him. Sending this guy next to the wall so that the tanks shoot at him and destroy it. Sending the helicopter there to rendezvous right away, not wasting any time on that one. Making sure there's no Gatling tanks down here below that will kill the second hero when you leave. And then just getting the heck out of there and getting to the other base as soon as possible. Now I'm going to spend a little more time... Oh yeah, making sure you get this. I'm going to spend a little more time controlling this hero here, because in attempts previous to this, it had gone wrong so many times. Like, they hadn't sold their stuff so many times. Like now, like everything is dead, but they haven't sold their stuff yet. They're waiting for me to kill one more Gatling cannon. It's really unreliable. Now there I was making sure that I didn't get hit by the task force of, like, three Gatling tanks and two Lasher tanks that spawns right at the top. Depends on what timing you do this with. You might run into them. Yep. Otherwise, done. You're done. As long as you killed all the grinders. And those racketeers can be substituted with GIs, too. You can just send GIs into a nearby building. But sometimes... they lose, so it's not as reliable as Rocketeers.
Our base is under attack. Establishing battlefield control. Stand by. Incoming transmission.
Satellite recon confirms that Yuri's got an operational silo in the area. Taking out those nukes is priority one. We have our own super weapon. One of Einstein's weather control machines. Use it on that base. Pronto!
This is the Space Needle, Commander. Garrisoning some GIs here will give us an excellent view of the city and allow us to better see what Yuri's forces are doing. Be careful when you approach the massive soft campus, sir. Yuri has guard units surrounding the main building. We can't afford to be caught by surprise. Battle control online.
There's not really much to say about this mission. You just need one sniper. I just did the P command again. And I'm gonna put this sniper guy, like, right next to the road. He actually comes so close to getting mind controlled. I'm gonna actually use the lightning strike to get those Yuris instead of what I usually do, which is get the task force that is in the upper right corner of that base, because you can just walk right past it, and I actually did it faster doing it this way, so that was good. Yeah, you can pretty much just rush these guys. It's pretty easy. Just take out the Yuris and just keep moving. it's a pretty easy mission.
Our base is under attack. Unit lost.
And I can just pretty much just like rush past him.
The weather control device back online. Unit lost.
Having this IFV alive really, really helps, of course, because he is elite and he'll do, like, so much damage. But yeah, other than that, that's pretty much it.
Unit lost. Mission accomplished. Establishing battlefield control. Stand by. Incoming transmission. We've tracked the professor to a secret base here in Egypt. You'll have to construct your own base. Special Agent Tanya will be available to assist you with the professor's rescue. He's being held in a secret base near the large pyramid. There are oil fields to the east. Our new tank destroyers can easily cut through Yuri's forces here. Good luck. The German tank destroyer was designed to punch through vehicle armor. It's effective against enemy tanks, but it does very little damage to buildings. Incoming transmission.
Help me across the river, Commander, and I'll make your life a whole lot easier. Snatch the good doctor from Yuri's goons, and be out of there before they even know what hit him.
New construction options.
Here. Here again, I'm going to use a P command. I'm going to take off while she's still kind of stepping on to the helicopter square. I'm going to just go across the river.
Commander, beware of Yuri's psychic
power. This is pretty self-explanatory. There's not much to say about this.
Mindless slaves to Yuri. Destroying the tower or cutting its power will free up any controlled units.
No problem. I'm trained to resist mind control.
I thought she was on a waypoint there, so I didn't do anything.
Gotcha. Nothing to stop me. Let's go.
I don't know why she walked up. Must have had something to do with the walls, but she like never does that. So I'm gonna get some waypoints set up for while I'm frozen in the cutscene.
Well done, sir. You've rescued Einstein. Transportation
gotta
is
do
on route to take him to safety.
Sometime anyway, so
Commander, apparently the
so that's going to take your view over here. I'm going to get back, finish this waypoint, and then I'm going to put the helicopter on a waypoint to explore the area that Tanya eventually has to go.
Once the psychic dominator is activated, you will have control over the targeted group of
Yuri's troops. Done. I can go.
I displayed the time remaining before the device
get ready for the
dominator.
Much,
so make your move.
I put these on teams according to their vehicle type. Then I'm just gonna make the tanks target the the Gatling tanks because they will automatically target the initiates, and that'll lead to them fucking dying. So that's pretty much the only thing I do. Yeah, just common sense. Just target what the unit is best at destroying. And I'm gonna destroy these transports first because, well, I'll eventually have to destroy them anyway, and they do lead to promotions more often than a lot of other things, so just to get some experience on my tanks here. As soon as you attack this construction yard, it'll trigger a bunch of units, including one Lasher, one Gatling, and a bunch of initiates. And this can get you a lot of the time. But it wasn't too bad this time. So I'm gonna send Tanya over here to get ready for the for the miners coming over. And I mean, maybe it could be sped up a little bit by having her go to where the miners are to begin with. But who knows?
Unit promoted.
So there's some specific bioreactors that have initiates in them, which increases the power output. So those are the ones that you want to target. Just leave the ones on the top alone because those don't have any extra initiates in them. But these ones on the bottom do, and this will get you a faster time because their power will be taken down faster. So, she can't do more than one at a time. I mean, maybe if you, like, really manipulate the slaves well,
unit lost.
She could, but, more often than not, she'll do one, and then if you try to do another one, she'll die. But, after they sell everything, the miners will just stand still and not be even able to attack for some reason. So she can just kind of walk her way through there when that happens. And then she can obviously see that I targeted all three of the miners, but she skipped one or something, or her C4 doted out or something. I don't know. But that's it. So this is the second hardest mission for me, and I don't know if there's a simpler way to do it than the way I do it, but the way I do it is pretty complicated.
Yuri's cloning facility is located in Sydney,
and I fail on it a lot. I'm really, really I was so
we'll launch our offensive near
so
the
surprised
house.
That I lab is was able to do both this
also reports that
and the second mission correctly
in
the same go.
Yuri's boomer submarines have
I just didn't really think it would ever happen.
Send dolphins and destroyers out as soon as you detect them.
The only thing that I would redo about this run,
our
if I could, was
attack.
The last mission.
Unit
where I wasted a minute killing the units. Otherwise, all these missions
battle
are pretty
control online.
Good. So, making some GIs right off the bat to fill up this building. Selecting all the Guardian GIs, but not moving the one that got chaos. Moving these dolphins into place so they'll lure the boomers into an infinite paralysis. And then moving the Guardian GIs back there so they can actually help destroy the boomers. And waiting for that one to become unchaosed and then moving him back there as well. Make sure to repair this pillbox because they will fucking rape it like super fast because initiates are fucking broken. And they have the hospital at this point. So they're actually really lethal right now. I made those two engineers to capture the hospital and the airfield, and then I'm going to make the rally point over here for the building that you need to garrison to kill the second miner that will result from the first base being destroyed. So these five initiates, they will kill your shit if you don't do something. I mean, they're definitely really capable of it. Sometimes they don't.
We're picking up a fleet of enemy subs moving on your position, Commander.
Sometimes they do. So,
I'm gonna
follow this helicopter around and customize his flying patterns so he doesn't have to stop and go over a bunch of buildings, because that slows him down. It's not really necessary, but I just feel like, I mean, it's a speed run, so I shouldn't just let him get stuck at a bunch of buildings. Build my barracks here, build some GIs immediately, get your tanks over here, build a spy and a Navy SEAL. Between the time that the GIs come out and the spy and the SEAL come out, I'm going to move the rally point for that barracks, moving those GIs down there so they can eventually get the first miner that results from the first base being destroyed. I'm going to move these GIs into this building and immediately target this psychic tower so I can get the one back that I just lost. And once it kills everything except for the Gatling that's out of range, I'm going to move him into the next one. I'm going to target this bioreactor with the tanks so as to lure the assortment of enemies that is on task to defend this base over to this building so I can destroy them. I'm going to move this spy a little bit around his natural trajectory so he doesn't get run over by those tanks. I'm gonna put him in right away, and right when he gets in, I'm gonna put this SEAL to kill the barracks. I'm gonna move these GIs around the miner. Now sometimes this tank is like right next to the barracks, which results in him like running over the SEAL, and if he is, then the next tank also is right next to the war factory, which results in him running over the SEAL definitely. Like, you can't even get away from it with the war factory if that tank is in that spot. So sometimes I've had to redo the entire run just because those tanks were in the wrong spot. It's just crazy. So just kill those cloning vats and the rest of their production facilities right away as soon as you can, and then send the SEAL down there because you don't really need him for this spot anymore. I'm gonna put this paradrop here to help with the miner in case he gets out of hand for these current GIs that are there. I'm gonna send the SEAL over to get the first miner from the second base. Actually, there might only be one. No, there's two miners. So I'm gonna get the first miner from the second base. The second one is right there, actually, that you see. The one stationary right now. Now, you have to follow this dude. And you have to... engaging him definitely helps, because it'll make him stop. But you have to follow him, otherwise he'll go all the way to your base, and then you have to wait for him to get there, and then kill him there. And it's a lot faster if you stop him, which requires some good GI control, as you just saw. And then I'm going to move and get... Oh yeah, and then this is the second miner from that base, as I was talking about. That's the first miner from the second base. The second miner from the second base is dying right there, as you can see. Yeah, he just died. Killed the Gatling cannon, killed the second tower. Now the SEAL is free to move in. Actually, the SEAL comes so close to dying, and the entire run would have been bunk, because the time would have just been too messed up. I'm so close to dying, it's ridiculous. So right about this time you want to be killing those, so they'll come in and the jets will come in and kill the naval yards. Because sometimes if the seal, if you have the seal blow up the naval yards, he'll die from it, from the shrapnel. Yeah, but as you can see, he just came so close to dying. Other than that, it's pretty much done right now. Just gonna kill the last few pieces of enemy. Yeah, so for this mission, you do have to kill the buildings. For the last mission, you only have to kill the units, and that's a very important distinction. I think I actually got a record that time on that mission. That's the fastest I've ever done that.
Establishing battlefield control. Stand by. Incoming transmission.
This is a very important meeting, Commander. If this treaty is ratified, the Soviet forces will join us in the battle against Yuri. We'll set up our defenses by the Parliament building. My money says Yuri will launch an offensive from the east. He might even sneak down the Thames River. We've got to build us an impenetrable air and sea defense. The leaders are already arriving. If they get killed or mind-controlled, everything we've done up till now won't mean diddly. Comprende?
You don't want the Vice President running the country, do you?
Which way, comrade?
Battle control online.
So, the 16-minute auto-scroller.
Securing position. Engineering.
Yeah, it's a good thing time has just started in this. Because that would really suck for a speed. Oh, wait, no, we do go by game time. Never mind, it really does suck. Yeah, Joseph had complained about this mission and the next mission being so long, and I agree with him. It really sucks. from a speedrunning standpoint, that you have to... that there's just a certain amount of time that you can't do anything to circumvent.
New construction options.
So this mission is all about GI placement, really. And knowing what you're doing with the buildings. I don't even need to talk about this from a speedrunning standpoint, really. A lot of this commentary will just be from a gameplay standpoint, because there is no way to speed this up faster than it already goes, other than killing the units as soon as they come onto the map, which I do. That's pretty much it, but that doesn't need explanation. So I'm going to make another barracks up here to pump out some GIs closer to where they need to end up. I'm going to start by just putting one GI in each building that I want to lay claim to, just to remind myself to put more GIs in that building, just so organization is easier. I'm going to capture these oil derricks, and normally I would put a fence so enemy units couldn't get in there, because they actually ignore it if there's a fence there. If there's not, though, they like see it and want to destroy it, I guess. But I just decided not to this time, and it could have bit me in the ass, but the enemy units definitely didn't get anywhere near there. So I'm going to put some GIs in these buildings next to the river, so that when, because amphibious transfers will come up the...
Construction complete.
Now, building the war factory up here is... I mean, it's a good idea, but also keep in mind that, like... your ore miners will come out of there still, and they'll just like slowly drive across all the way across the bridge to get back to your base. So you know, if you notice that one is coming out, it's good to just have him to select him and have him teleport over to your base instead.
Unit reporting.
I'm like, well, should I put them down there yet? No, that's right, I have to do something else still. Yeah, so like you just saw, teleporting the ore miners. So I'm going to kill these trees so I can build the fence around this, because otherwise they will literally kill that building the first thing they do. Like, within seconds of any enemy units appearing on the map, that building will be dead. So I'm gonna build some walls around it, and it actually serves to, like, totally rape them, actually, in the end, so, it's just a good idea. And then I'm gonna put a wall around two other buildings as well. I only started doing that recently. I mean, it's not essential, but it does lead to my buildings not even, like, dying at all in this run, I believe.
Construction complete. Unit ready. Building. Construction complete. Low power. Building.
I am gonna build an ore purifier because there is a relatively limited amount of ore, but mostly for the reason that you're just building so much stuff, like so many GIs and like tanks, with that limited amount of ore, and you have no way of getting any more at all until you pass the first part. So I'm gonna build that ore purifier.
Unit ready.
And I stand by that decision. I do think it helps significantly.
Building. Unit ready.
Start filling out these buildings. Complete. Finishing
incoming
the walls.
Transmission.
You cannot win, Commander. Soon.
And I love the first time that I did this run.
And the Allied leaders.
Yuri,
under my
control. Not this run, but soon you the first video I uploaded of this this mission,
perhaps
my disc glitched right when Yuri started talking, and he's like, "Wing Commander, Wing Commander, Wing Commander."
Unit ready.
I think of that every time I hear that now. And there's other hilarious things that have ensued from that I still think about, but that's one of the biggest ones. Give me money.
Unit ready.
Thank you. God, they mine in such an obtrusive fashion. They just mine diagonally and they go like so far away from your base, so it takes them longer. It's so dumb. But if you're really like a control freak, you can actually increase their efficiency by. I mean, I guess it's not increasing their efficiency because you have to get it all eventually anyway. But if you need money fast, you can.
Construction complete.
Manually target the ore closer to your base. I'm building a little more of my base here. I mean, I'm pretty confident that they're not gonna come. It's kind of funny actually. They do end up coming. They actually get in at like the point I would least expect that I usually pay the least attention to, but it doesn't result from anything because it's only initiates.
Training. Unit ready.
Everything's made to fit. In or on the go.
So I built 7 IFVs, and that seems to be the magic number. I built
unit
6,
ready.
And they've all died. I built 8, and they've just all raped the everything. 7
got
seems
it.
To be a cool middle.
Everything's made to fit.
Unit
did
ready.
I build 7?
Unit ready.
Thought I built 7.
I hope you're ready, Commander.
Yeah, so I don't really like put like any defense back here because they don't. I mean, a few units get back to Parliament, but the one building takes care of them, honestly. And even if like even when the boomers catch me off guard, and you'll see these initiates just kind of getting past me there. But even if the boomers catch me off guard and like totally rape Parliament into the yellow, like you can still just build an engineer from the barracks back there and repair it, and then like it's fine. Until you can get something back there. It's like Parliament just like never dies. It's pretty easy to
find. Unit ready.
Can do. Moving out. Orders?
Unit ready.
Double time.
Training. Unit ready.
Squared away, sir.
So I built 5 Mirage Shanks, 5 Prism Shanks, and then 5 more Mirage Shanks. The first 5 Mirage Shanks will be guarding the Prism Shanks. Oh yeah, and those grizzly tanks are down there to kill the amphibious transport if it happens to make it that far. As you can see, they just kind of get raped with that wall there. They just kind of...
Training.
And then the second five Mirage tanks will be to handle kind of the residual...
Unit ready.
Enemy units that... For example, the initiates that attack the machine shop and...
Building.
The miners, especially, because the miner will go all the way around to your base, and it's just terrible as far as time is concerned. But I do pretty well this run.
Unit ready.
I do satisfactorily. I don't know what I'm doing there. I'm just like looking everywhere. Oh, I made 8?
Complete.
Oh, that's weird. I didn't mean to. You don't need 8, you only
Yuri
need 7.
Calls this thing a mastermind. It's basically a big brain.
Spy satellite definitely helps.
Anything that gets near
it actually is essential if you want to use the Chrono Legionnaire the way I do, which is I use him to kill the naval yard. It's essential to have the spy satellite for that. These guys land. I don't really care. I mean... I do wonder how many guys I have in that one building that is within range of hitting
Build up the defenses.
That transport, though. And I don't know who just hit Parliament. It's like, there was no one near it, so it was weird. But who cares? I could even come close tonight. So right about now I'm thinking, okay, well this is about the end, or it's close to the end, so... Better move my prism tanks over there because they're slow as shit, and these masterminds just get raped too. It's awesome. I love the wall idea.
Unit ready.
Parliament is under attack.
So team one of Mirage tanks, we're gonna go over and meet up. And then I'm like, wait a minute. Oh, I should take like 2 more because.
Going mobile.
You always want more Mirage tanks than Prism tanks. Like, okay, where's the end here? I always love putting my Chrono Legionnaires on team 0 or 9. Ever since multiplayer, where you'd have like those just one or two around to get any crates, like especially on those huge modded maps or the custom maps where like crates,
unit
like
lost.
You just sit around for hours and all you do is like gather crates and build armies.
Unit
so yeah, this is the last wave and they pretty much get fucking raped because I have awesome defenses.
Don't let Parliament fall.
Hey, don't fuck
our
with my power. Oh yeah, and then I'm like,
low
I have low power, I should build another power plant. But it's only because this asshole's draining my
unit
power.
Promoted. Repairing.
Yuri's attacking Parliament. Build up.
Nobody cares, dude.
Unit ready.
Got that transport. We're gonna move these ones up a little bit.
Battle control offline.
Put those on a team.
Incoming transmission.
That was some fine work, Commander. The treaty's been signed. We've tracked down the location of Yuri's London base. Soviet forces will be joining us any time now. Use them. Burn that base to the ground and scatter the...
Burn that base to the ground! It's like a movie. So the first thing you want to do here is get your Chrono Legionnaire up next to the naval base because he takes super long to kill it. And you might end up waiting on him unless you do that. And then move your transports up here so you can have some to defend from the boomers.
Structure abandoned.
Move these guys up there because they do actually engage the miner, because that's the route he takes, but they end up just getting killed by the initiates, which doesn't really matter because the miner wasn't even close to there anyway.
Unit lost.
They just get raped. The initiates are so broken.
Unit lost. Structure abandoned.
Kill the miner.
Unit promoted.
Oh wait, I can't because he's leaving. Bye. I don't know how the so dumb the Raj tanks like decide that they don't have enough room and so they go all the way around the wall and get mind controlled. It's retarded.
Unit lost. Unit promoted.
Like, unit okay, lost. I don't know why you did
unit
that.
Promoted. Green and unseen.
Going mobile adjusting stabilizer. Kilovarius, do it! Kill. Oh wait, it doesn't matter because the Nailbeard isn't dead yet. Good, because I felt like I took too long to kill the barracks. Now it is dead. Kill the barracks! Kill the barracks! There you go. And that is it. That is all she wrote. If you let them live for too long, then they'll like build another miner, or the miner will get like all the way to your base, and then it'll take long, like crazy long.
Incoming transmission.
Our forces will deploy at Tierra del Fuego, at the southernmost tip of South America. You'll have to repair this abandoned Soviet base. The cliffs surrounding the Antarctic shoreline make a naval assault impossible. Once you get radar up and running, we'll chrono in an MCV. Yuri's transmissions are coming from the east. We're rooting for you, Commander. The whole world is watching and waiting.
Battle control.
I was so nervous when I got to this mission. So send the engineer to get the Tesla reactor first, obviously, because that's the longest thing that takes the longest. Or one of the two at least. And I don't even use this radar, this radio building, but like, I found that there's like nothing else to do with that engineer besides maybe capture the oil derrick. But I don't fuck with that when speedrunning it, so I'm just like, whatever, I'll just put him in here so he won't get genetically mutated and piss me off later.
Building. Training. Unit ready.
Yeah, I was so nervous, like I like never thought I would get a run where like all these missions actually went correctly, because it has just been so many tries with something going wrong every time. So yeah, I'm just building a really simple defense strategy, just building the two battle bunkers, one at each entrance, and the attacking units from the right will actually curl in and then down, and so they'll actually engage the battle bunker automatically, and the wall that's around it will incidentally protect it for a little while anyway. So that's a good spot for that. You can use the radio building, but you don't need to. And I built my ore refinery right next to the ore just so I can get that cash flow going as fast as possible. And I actually don't even build another one, and I actually end up having a really small amount of cash later.
New construction options.
Partially because of that, but it doesn't matter. I had enough. It didn't slow me down. The main thing is just getting a bunch of cash right away so you don't get, because otherwise you'll get slowed down in your build order and
construction
in your build process for the Allied base.
We're searching for a suitable landing zone to chrono in your MCV.
Up a necessary time.
Just hold off Yuri's forces for a little longer. Training. Unit ready.
Send this dog down here. Dogs have more sight than conscripts, so he can actually see enough into the water to build your naval shipyard, and then later he'll prove a very convenient target for the genetic mutator, for both parties actually, because if you don't let it go off, then later when you do your spies, it will.
Construction complete.
It'll building. Just mutate your frickin' spies, and then your whole
options.
Process for that would be messed up. That happened to me. Pretty much screwed up my entire plan. Because the oral derricks just got blown up before I could even spy them. I'm just going to engage these tanks that you don't really need to, but I just
set. 4, 3, 2, 1.
Press spacebar, it'll take you to where the Allied MCV was chronoed in. I'm going to send one. Construction complete. Or yeah, I sent one ore miner over to get this other ore
unit ready.
Preemptively so that my cash flow wouldn't slow down. And it slowed down a tiny bit, but not as bad as it would have if I hadn't done that. Because otherwise it'll just always slow down right here. But he's probably about to like. No, it did slow down.
Structure garrisoned.
But he's a little bit closer to emptying than he otherwise would have been. So yeah, the only way to stop that is by manually making him empty his load.
Select target. Repairing.
Before it's full. So I'm gonna make the rally point for this war factory down here. Found that spot to be the best for handling the two different directions the flying discs come from. And you can also build a flat cannon. You definitely have enough power. I just didn't feel like it, or I don't know. Could maybe save you money, but I haven't really experimented with that much. I just built it a few times and then. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, you could probably replace like two of the flak tracks with a flak cannon. I don't know if they would drain your power with that or how that would work.
Training. New rally
so,
unit ready.
I did uncover the oil derricks a little bit late in this run, which
unit ready.
Resulted in only one of the. Of the units in my first chronosphere being elite or promoted. You do want to uncover that, like, go down there, go! Okay. You do want to uncover that, I would say around the time you start building your battle lab or. A little bit before that, because the way I did it just did not work out. You want to make sure you capture one of them so they will attack it eventually, blowing it up and blowing their entire base up so they can't send attacking units at you from there. And you'll see what I do with this spy. It's actually essential to my attacking process on this mission, because if you don't get your units elite, then they'll just fucking die. I mean promoted. I keep saying elite, but that's 3 stars.
Everything's made to fit.
I'm like, my instinct is to not kill him, but then I realize that I should have.
Watch my dust.
Training.
I hadn't done this mission in a while at this point. Just been focusing on the earlier missions in my practice.
Need a repair?
So now I have to fucking capture it all over again and shit.
Our base is under attack.
Need a repair?
Yeah. Construction complete. Repairing.
Find a fucking place to build this.
Unit ready. Cannot deploy here.
Vehicle ready.
New construction options. Building.
Transformer panels in order.
I was also like super drunk when I did this. So maybe. Yeah. This is risky because the IFE might get controlled or killed or something. So I was pretty nervous about doing that. Set the rally point to buy the genetic mutator for these dreadnoughts. Because if they go there, if they go like anywhere to the left of that,
unit ready.
Well, I guess I should say anywhere up from that, they will get assaulted by boomers. But at that spot and other spots along the coast, the boomers will attack you and they'll follow you for a little while, but then they'll get bored and they'll leave.
Insufficient
it's weird.
Funds.
I don't know.
Repairing.
So make sure you do it at a spot close to the coast, but obviously not close enough to get attacked by the units on the coast.
Warning. Genetic mutator activated.
And as you can hear, that that genetic mutator just went off. I pressed spacebar to go to the spot that on the map that it was used, and it went to an empty spot because when you genetically mutate a dog, it just disappears. It doesn't turn into a brute. So, I'm pretty late on this one, so I'm like, come on, come on, come on. So I'm going to spy this war factory.
Unit ready.
And then my units will start coming out as elite. Yeah, so my defense strategy here is pretty simple, again, with just the two Mirage tanks and the one battle bunker. I had experimented with different strategies, like three battle bunkers and walls across the rest of the whole thing. And I mean, that was good, but it was just unnecessary. And then besides, sometimes they would just like go around and come up from underneath my base. And this is just a waste.
Unit
and
ready.
This works. So.
Perfect hideout.
Yeah, so I started fire with a dreadnought. It's not really going to do anything. It just has a when there's only one, it just kind of has a chance of destroying one of the Gatling tanks, but they're about to come get me anyway once I attack this. So, a very important piece of information. On this mission, if you look at the briefing, it words it differently than on Clones Down Under. It's like, make sure that all enemy, or finish off all enemy units or something. Which means you only have to kill the units. You don't have to kill any of the buildings. So, and I've experimented with so many different ways of doing this faster, and of ways of just targeting the units and getting those kind of taken out really, really fast. I've experimented with so many ways. Believe me.
Or minor under attack.
But this has proven to be the fastest, and it's really kind of disappoints me that I couldn't find a faster way, because this way is just so simple and boring. It's the way that everyone does this mission, and I just experimented with rocketeers, with spies, with flak tracks full of conscripts with crazy Ivan bombs on them. That was fun. It didn't speed things up ultimately, but it was fun. I wish one of those ways had worked, but yeah, back to the basics, I suppose. So there's like hella Yuris down to the left right now for some reason. I don't know how they got there. So now that I have a few more, it'll actually start doing some damage to the genetic commutator.
Unit lost.
Did you run down? Pronounce my words. Wow. Can't even pronounce.
Unit
pronounce.
Ready.
Some in previous runs, I had gone up and attacked that those two psychic towers from the actual cliff that they're on. But it's kind of a waste of time. Okay, and how come the Yuris? They're just hanging out back there for some reason. Oh, no, stop! Oh, what the fuck's going on? Oh, tank control. What is? Anyway, I experimented with that, but just takes too much time and. You can hit the one psychic tower from below the cliff, so I just settled for just hitting that one and inching my way around the other one. Now that the genetic mutator is dead, I'm gonna send the dreadnoughts. Oh god, mastermind. Never mind. Oh god, sometimes these magnetrons will shoot a beam, and then they'll start driving away while shooting the beam, which is something that I can almost guarantee you that humans cannot do, and it's super unfair that the computer can do that, and it's so just annoying, so annoying when it happens.
Unit ready.
But luckily they didn't do it that time. So I'm going to send the dreadnoughts over, and I attack those bioreactors. If you take out all four of those, their power will go down, which results in their base defenses being rendered obsolete, which, I mean, it just kind of helps. You can just kind of walk through their base and just target the units, which helped a lot more when I was experimenting with different ways of... Wait a minute, they're not in the right spot. Okay, there we go.
Insufficient funds. Chronosphere ready. Warning.
This has been the best use of the Chronosphere so far. I mean, you can put the second chronosphere below their base, You can do all sorts of things with it, but it's just simply not, I don't know what the word I'm looking for is. It's not good to try to control two task forces at once. It just doesn't really work on this mission. At least for me. Maybe you could do it. I don't know. You might be Superman.
Unit ready.
But the rest of the mission is pretty much just grind.
Unit promoted.
Focusing on the units, of course. The point that I messed up on this mission was I mean it wasn't really me messing up, it was just bad luck. Where they had a task force made at the time that I finished killing everything else. Which, if I had known about, I could have killed it sooner, but I didn't, and I didn't expect it. But it took me like a minute to find and kill. And the miners, important piece of information here, I actually don't think you have to kill the miners, even the ones that come to your base. I think you might just be able to leave them and kill the rest of the units instead. But I did, just to be safe, I did kill the miners. Because, I mean, think about it. If I had gone and killed, like... Actually, you don't even know what I'm talking about. I'll just wait. Never mind. So I'm going to kill this psychic tower so my Mirage Tanks can go through and finish off the last unit in this half of the map in their base. Now there's this...
Unit ready.
This miner here, and I don't want my prism tanks to shoot at him because they'll shoot right through my construction yard and they will fucking rape it. They'll probably kill it.
Our base is under attack. Our base is under attack.
At this point, I'm just trying to find what units are holding me up. And it's actually, they're actually to the south here. They're coming to attack me. See this task force. And actually, I mean, that doesn't look like a task force. It might just be like left over. No, yeah, that is a task force. This task force decided to attack me right when I finished killing the entire rest of their base, so it took time to go ahead and finish them off before the mission could end. Finish these guys off, and then there's more. I don't know what those guys. It looks like a team for guarding the miners, but they're not really right next to the miners. And there's not a Yuri with them, so I don't know what they're doing, really.
Our base is under attack.
Very weird.
Unit ready.
And it made me lose a lot of time. Anyway, that's it. You just have to kill the units. As you can see, there are still some miners left.
Mission accomplished.
Yeah, so that was my one blunder, was the minute there. I've gotten 1630 on... before.